Hello, good morning out there. I am Kim Kesty here in the Creative Classroom at Spellbinders, and super excited to be back here again on a Friday, as we try to do every Friday. We are at a new time now. We're broadcasting in the morning our live videos, but again, welcome. I'm going to really have fun today because I am kind of showcasing not one, but two different brand new collections that we have just launched. Now, Spellbinders, as some of you who have been around for a while know, that pretty much every month, I guess I would say every month, we launch brand new collections. And now for the month of February, on February 20th, which is just a few days ago, we launched, I think, four or five new collections. So exciting. But I'm going to play with two of them today and mix and match them. They work so well together. So I thought it would be a fun thing to do on our Tri-Day Friday, which is what we typically call our Friday versions of our live videos. So let's take a look at the two collections. I think you're going to love them. I actually kind of just have a sampling. I think I have more of Yana's Bloomin' Birthdays than I do of Sushma's, but let's talk about Yana's first. I'm actually going to be using the second on my project, but then we'll transition to Sushma's collection. Now, Yana has a great collection called Yana's Blooming Birthdays, and those of you who are Yana fans, which we all are out there, it's for us here at Spellbinders, and this is her latest one. So let's just look real quick. Let's start with the birthday candles, since it's a birthday collection. You will see as I go through them that they are not just all birthday. This is actually a really great collection that you are going to use all year round. But it does have this really cute birthday borders, and I've got this fun little card here that we did with the rainbow foil. Look how fun! And you could actually foil this plate. It is a glimmer plate. Let me flip it over and show you. Twice on your card front too, and that covers your whole background of your A2. So if you did it again here, you would have birthday candles all over. So cute. Love that one. We've got some great sentiments, which actually pair with her other sentiment set. I'll kind of put those two together. These work and mix and match well together, or you can use them on their own, of course. This little one too, look how cute. It's like little tiny baby sentiments. So cute. I'm actually going to be layering one of those up on my project today. And here's a fun card featuring some of those sentiments and the next little item here, which is the diamond floral frame. And I promise I'm going to get to crafting really quick here. I'm going to be using this in today's project too, but just wanted to show you a fun little showcase of that. And these two items too are awesome. I'm going to set these aside because I'm going to use these in a future video for Tri-Day Friday. This is the tiny stripe background, or Yana calls it the skinny stripe. And then this really cool peony, the glimmering peony. What a beautiful, beautiful plate. Okay, one more floral too. Can't forget this one. This actually reminds me a lot of Sushma's. And this is actually the glimmer plate that kind of led me into pulling in Sushma stamps for today's video, because look, I mean, they're so gorgeous. They work so well together. So let me pop those two away here. And speaking of Sushma's, I don't even have all of her stamps available, but Sushma Head, I got to get this name right now, Hegde. Hopefully I'm saying that right, Hegde. Sushma is an amazing watercolor artist. She has an awesome, awesome Instagram feed, so you definitely want to check that out. I'm going to ask our moderator to go ahead and pop that into the comments. So Sushma's an amazing artist. So she hand draws all these beautiful watercolors, which you will see if you check out that feed. And we met her on one of our trade show adventures over there in Europe, in Germany actually. And she had her beautiful portfolio with her, and it just kind of became this brilliant idea that, you know, not everybody can draw as well as Sushma. Certainly I can't. So we went ahead and translated some of her beautiful drawings into clear stamps. And so that's what I'm going to be using today. Like I said, we have more even than I'm showing here, but this one is just a beautiful collection of greenery and blooms. I'll actually show you the little card made with that one. This is the one where you can take all those little blooms and look how beautiful. Translate into this gorgeous border and add just a little bit of fun color, whether it's markers or watercolors or whatever medium you want, and you just have this stunning, stunning look. Looks like you're truly an artist. Now this guy, I don't think I have a card for this guy. This one's really pretty though. It's got a little bit longer stems, and a lot of them have these beautiful sentiments that match. This guy I wanted to show off because it's really pretty. It's the only one we have in the collection that's a layered stamp. And I know that those of you who love clear stamping and doing layered blooms are absolutely going to flip for this one. And look how beautiful. Just by choosing a few different inks and stamping away, you've got this actual look like you spent hours watercoloring this card. So absolutely love that one. That's the layered wildflowers. And this guy is the one I'm going to use today, so I'll kind of pull it out. You can see I've already been stamping away with it, so it's a little bit hard to tell, but this is called Beauty in Bloom, and here's a sample that we did earlier. One of our designers did. I didn't create this card, but see how pretty to layer up those blooms? You'll see when I start my card that I went a little bit different way, but I absolutely love that sample. So, let's get to it. I went ahead and grabbed this Beauty in Bloom stamp, and I'll just kind of pop it out here so you can see. And those of you who maybe some of you have never done clear stamping. I don't know. That could be. The stamps just come individually on this little backer card, and you can see that this one, for example, I've already inked. And you can clean them off a little bit better with ink cleaner. I just went ahead and stamped a bunch of flowers in a kind of a pattern to match the triangle from Yana's collection, Glimmer, and I'm going to pull that in a minute. But I wanted to first talk about our new cardstock. This is just a few of the colors of the new cardstock, the Color Essentials cardstock that Spellbinders now has. And I wish I could be out here to touch it because it's 100-pound paper and it's so gorgeous. So these are just a few of the colors that I pulled out for today's card. But this is our Snowdrift White. And I just went ahead and trimmed a panel and I used all of our clear stamps. I'm going to grab a block. I stamped mine already, so I'm just going to kind of show you how you would use it. So you would just adhere your clear stamps onto any of your acrylic blocks you have. We have these beautiful blocks here at SpellbindersPaperArts.com, of course, in all different sizes. So you would just adhere it to that, and then you would use any of your black ink. Because I am doing some watercolor, and you're going to want to choose an ink that's waterproof. I have this Fun Stampers Journey Fusion ink, which we do have here on the website, and that works beautifully. And then I also grabbed this because some of you may have something like this in your stash. This is the Ranger Archival ink, which is also waterproof. So any kind of waterproof black ink, and then you just want to stamp away. You can use a stamp positioner or not. And here is my, ta-da, through the magic of television, we have this whole little background stamped. So all I did was I took all the little individual pieces and just kind of stamped them in a ring. Now remember I said I was going to use one of the pieces from Yana's collection? So this diamond floral frame I thought was perfect. So I went ahead and glimmered it. So I also glimmered it on the same cardstock, the Snowdrift. And then her die, or her glimmer plates, I wanted to point out, also come with the matching dies. So I think this is fantastic. It's such a thoughtful design choice to make. So once you glimmer all these items, then you can cut them out. And the diamond actually has two sizes of diamonds, so you can layer it up, which I'm also going to do. I hope I'm not talking too fast. I kind of want to like get through it, but not, you know, take all of your Friday morning here. But you can see that I have this glimmered and already die cut out. And this is really the shape that I used when I stamped my flowers. So you can see why I stamped them in this particular pattern. I didn't worry about filling in the middle because guess what? Ta-da! I knew it was going to be covered. So I just kind of had this die cut already ready when I was stamping these flowers. So I kind of started here and I worked my way around and just kind of kept referring to my diamond as I stamped my flowers. And I think I did pretty good, right? It looks like it's, you know, pretty much the right shape. Of course, it's not even around. You don't want it to be because it's just supposed to be fun wildflowers, right? It's so much fun. Okay, so now that I have my panel stamped, and I do want to point out that this cardstock is not watercolor cardstock. If you did stamp it on watercolor cardstock, that would be fantastic too, and you could probably get a lot of different fun looks. Mine is just straight up plain cardstock, but it also works fine. I am not going to be saturating this paper too much. I'm not a true watercolorist, you know, so I'm just going to be doing kind of light strokes on here. So the weight, the 100-pound weight paper works just fine. Now before I pop this open, I should point out this is one of our little Jane Davenport color palettes for watercolors. She actually has three different color palettes like this, and look how cute they are. Are they like the most adorable thing you've ever seen? This is her Brights palette, and she has two other palettes too, which of course you can also check out on our website. You can just, we'll put a link in, but you can also just search on our website, you know, Jane Davenport watercolors or whatnot. I also grabbed one of our little bloom palettes here, and that's just a little plastic palette. Now my blending brushes I have here have just plain water in them. So this happens to be the small one, and I have a medium one too. So just plain water. These work great because you can squeeze out a little bit of water out of the tip. Actually, I'm going to switch to yellow. I'm going to do yellow first. and they kind of clean themselves. So you just add a little bit of water. You can even just drop a couple drops of water on your little paint. What do you call this? A paint block? A paint wedge? Somebody's going to know what these little things are called. And then the water, of course, activates the watercolor. And you can kind of thin it out on your palette if you want. I started with what I consider my lightest color. And honestly, guys, like I am not a fantastic watercolorist, but I really enjoy it. And I really think it's an easy, forgiving medium because you don't have to be so exact. You can just come in, you can add a little bit of color, and you'll see in just a moment when I come in with a second color, how they kind of blend and meld together and kind of give me that great watercolor look. So I actually think watercolor is even easier than coloring, like, for example, with markers or something. I feel like you have to be more exact with those mediums. You guys have to leave your comments and tell me what you think, if you have tried watercoloring, if you enjoy it. And I'm going to activate my pretty pink color here. And I know Jane has all kinds of cute names for these colors too. I'm going to put pink here, but then I'm also going to grab some yellow out of my dish. And I kind of combine my pink and yellow to give me a kind of a fun little orangey corally color. So as we know, yellow and red or pink will create orange. So again, sometimes gently squeezing water out, and the watercolor goes a long way. You're going to get different tones. You're going to get some more peaches and some more pinks and some more oranges. But really, it's all about Sushma's amazing drawings. I mean, she really did all the work for us. She created these beautiful images, and I can just really just do the fun part. And again, the watercolor is fantastic because even after it dries a little bit, you can kind of come back and reactivate it and blend it a little bit too. So again, kind of starting with my peaches, and I won't do the whole thing. I have a panel I've actually already finished, but I wanted to get enough done so it could kind of dry a little bit. Of course, I would come back with my greens for my leaves. Now, I think watercolors are really supposed to be soft, but when I came in with some of my greens, and I did choose the Brights palette, of course, so I should know what I'm getting into. But I actually love the brightness of some of the greens from this palette because I figure, hey, springtime is the one time where everything is at its greenest. Am I right? Well, I know that's a fact for Arizona. If you wait too long into the past springtime, you're going to get a lot of really darker greens and a lot of more, what would you say, like dried out greens, that's for sure. So I love that some of these are, you know, a little bright, a little pop of color here. So as this panel dries and I would come back and I would add more layers, I could just have fun. You can really spend as much time as you want. Or if you want a quicker project, you can go, you know, a little quicker and not really fuss with it too much, and you're still going to get a really great look. I'm going to come back with a little pink now and just kind of share with you how I can do some highlights here with a little bit more of that pink that's not mixed with the yellow. And kind of let that come to life. So pretty. And I said to let this dry between layers, but you don't have to let it dry completely. What I meant was just kind of let the color set a little bit. Then when you come back, you can really have some fun with some blending. So again, you've got those fun pinky peachy undertones. And then you can just add your little bit more layers, pops of color. Ooh, I kind of love this one, how this one's turning out. I love where you get a lot of different, you know, shades and tones. Like, brings me back to my grade school days of mixing colors, right? Okay, I definitely could sit here all day in watercolor, and I'd love to chit-chat with you guys. By the way, be sure to leave comments for us, whether it's on our Facebook Live or our YouTube Live. We love our viewers on both channels. ask questions. I'm definitely going to alert both Yana and Sushma to come in and answer questions if you have. That would be super fun.
I am also here to answer questions live.
Yay!
Or to pass on questions live.
Exactly. So you would carry on, continue to watercolor, fill in all your little spots. I did leave my background bare, and then again, I chose one of our cardstocks to kind of pull in that fresh springy green. This particular color is Fern from our new cardstock collection. So I just folded this guy in half to make my card base. I did trim down my panel just a little bit. Let me show you what my finished watercolored panel looks like. I already popped it on my card base here. So maybe we can have Roy come in a little bit closer. I went ahead and again, you know, had fun watercoloring, didn't stress out too much about going inside, outside the lines. Kept it loose, kept it pretty. I did put a little bit darker red in for some of the little berries. I thought that was sweet. But again, just had so much fun. So now I was ready for my next step. We need to add a little diamond back in here, like I said, and then do some accents with some sentiments. So you guys will have to help me out here. I think I know which direction I'm going, but I always appreciate you guys chiming in. I'm gonna adhere my little diamond on here first. I'm using some foam squares to kind of pop it up. I like a little dimension. Make sure I got it kind of centered here. All right. So then I went ahead and, like I said, this glimmer set comes with the matching dies. I cut three different inside diamonds, which you can see are going to fit right inside that little glimmered line right there. And I really was debating on what color. I mean, they all look beautiful, right? So here we've got just a really pale peach, or that kind of pulls out a few of those peachy colors. But I looked at this one, I was like, I don't know if it goes with the green because it's so pale, but it's pretty, but I don't know. So then I went with this lighter pink, which I just kind of flashed by you here for a minute. I thought, ooh, that's really pretty. And I love pink and green. I feel like it's really preppy or whatever. And that was a nice color. Matched the watercolor too. I mean, really, you can't go wrong, right? And then I pulled out this darker one. This is actually just a little scrap I had. This isn't one of our new colors, but I was like, ooh, I kind of like that. I kind of like how that pulled out the depth of some of the colors in here. So what do you guys think? I'm going to give you just a minute to comment. Should I go light pink? Should I go peach? Or should I go dark pink? So I'm going to leave your choices right here while I pull out my sentiments, and we'll see if we get any reaction. I know a lot of you watched on the replay, but you can still vote even if you're watching on the replay. So let me grab my sentiment set so I can show you which ones I chose. I actually used both of my sentiments from Yana's special sentiment set. I'm moving my grid paper here. So this has really awesome. It has five large sentiments, which again have the matching dies. We just love that. And this set also has a couple of the small little supporting sentiments that work well. So I chose "You Are a Wonderful Friend." Thought that was really fun. And then I chose the little tiny happy birthday. And I thought that was fun to kind of support this guy and layer it up. So I'm going to turn this into a birthday card. I've got a special birthday coming up. So I will set that aside. I pre-glimmered these already. And but all three of these, by the way, just have our one of my favorite foils, which is the gold foil number 14. So if you're wondering what foil I used, that is it.
So we have a battle between Facebook and YouTube.
Oh dear, okay, so let's hear it. Facebook, which one are they liking first, the pinks or the peach?
Facebook seems to be leaning towards the dark pink.
The darker pink, okay.
Right now, YouTube is leaning light.
The light
pink. There's a couple for the peach also.
Oh, there's a couple peaches. See, I was thinking the peach might be a little too pale. We'll take the peach out of the running right now. So we'll say, if people want to vote again, dark pink or light pink? Roy's like, wait, we got to give him a second.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a delay.
I'm going to start adding adhesive to my sentiments while we give everyone like one more minute to vote. I'm putting foam in the back of these too. These are like little tiny pieces of foam that I just cut apart from my foam squares. Lets me get extra mileage out of my foam squares. Do you guys do that? Is anybody else who do that out there? one more piece, I think, on this one. One more piece on this one. All right, I got to peel my squares, and then I'm going to, like, go for it.
Still a split decision between the two platforms. A little bit of dark showing up on YouTube here, but it's mostly light.
Okay, I'm going to go for the light. I'm going to go for the gut, which I think is the one I was going to pick.
More darks on
kind
YouTube.
Of originally. People are like, no, dark, dark. Okay, I promise to do another panel because guess what, guys? I have this card to finish up. And you know how you watercolor every time things are a little bit different? I'm kind of already feeling like maybe this is going to have some darker tones. So I promise I will finish this card and I will use the dark pink over here. Deal? I don't want anyone to be mad.
You are a diplomat, Kim.
Well, I do got, you know, a lot of times when I do these lives, I have cards that are pre-prepped, and I do go back and finish them, I promise. All right, so my wonderful friend, I also popped up because I can't resist, and I want to make sure this is fairly straight. Now, Sushma has a really cute sentiment set, too. That would be fabulous, of course, with the stamps, too, but I thought, you know what, I'm going to kind of go for it with a mix and match. I'm going to put this one off center a tiny bit. Kind of tuck it under there. I don't feel like it has to be perfectly centered under the wonderful friend. But I thought this was really cute to mix and match. Now, of course, I could come back and I could add, you know, a few little sparklies or a few little gems. But I really think that because the watercolor is so fun and fabulous that you don't need to add a lot of extra, you know, finishing accents. And of course, the glimmer gives that little fun sparkle. Ooh, sparkle, sparkle. So much fun. All right, so again, super excited about all of our new releases here at Spellbinders. And of course, we would love for you to go check out our website, which is at spellbinderspaperarts.com. You can see it right there on the screen. Check them out. So again, these are not the only two new collections we have. We have a lot more. And as always, we have new things all the time. So definitely check that out. I hope you guys have a great weekend crafting. Go ahead and leave your comments or questions and we will go back and check them out. We love that. Have a fun weekend, and as always, enjoy bringing paper to life.